guys and welcome back to my channel. Wait a second.
So now my background is okay?
Hey you lovely people and welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, my name is Aditi and I really hope you guys are doing absolutely fantastic. First, talking about this look, I just finished filming a tutorial for my IGTV and which was on retro look. So comment fast and let me know how do you feel about this look. I really want to know. And now talking about this video, this is going to be a really interesting video because in this video, I'm going to tell you how to do a DIY facial. It's like a facial at home using green tea. It is going to be really helpful for you all because in this facial, the active ingredient is green tea. I have used green tea in each and every step, whether it is cleansing, scrubbing, masking, facial cream, facial massage, like everything. The active ingredient is green tea. And as you all know, green tea is a really good antioxidant which really helps to, you know, fade out the blemishes, the acne marks, helps to fight with the breakouts, and it really helps to, you know, get rid of the blackheads. So yes, and this facial is for all skin types, but it is particularly really good for the oily skin girls out there. So basically, the idea behind this video is like when you go out for the facial, like a green tea facial, you have to burn your pockets for about ₹2,000 to 3,000. But here you can get it totally free. Plus, in this video, I'm going to tell you how to massage your face. Because if you are massaging your face in a wrong way, then it can be reason of your fine lines, wrinkles. So I'm going to tell you how to massage your face, like the movements, the pressure points, which, you know, really help to relax and calm your skin down. And all the ingredients in this facial are easily available in your kitchen. If you are not a green tea person, then I will surely say that please add green tea in your daily routine because it keeps you active whole day. When you, you know, have a cup of green tea in the morning, it keeps you fresh and active whole day. So without wasting time, let's jump into the video. The very first thing that you will need is this. This is the green tea. I'm putting this bag aside because I will definitely need this in other steps. Next, leave it for 2 or 3 hours to let it cool down in a room temperature. Now the step number one is cleansing. First, I'm going to tell you how you have to prepare your cleansing product and then I will tell you the use of cleansing. So for cleansing, take a bowl, an empty bowl, and now I have this raw milk and I'm adding 1 tablespoon of this raw milk. Then I'm adding 1 tablespoon of this green tea and 1/2 tablespoon of this freshly squeezed lemon juice, and now mix it well. So once you are done with this, take a cotton pad, dip it into this mixture, squeeze off the excess, and now clean your face with this. First, make sure that your face is clean, you have nothing on it, and make sure your hands are also clean because you do not want to work with, you know, dirty hands. So basically, I had 3 ingredients in this cleansing. One, the raw milk. Raw milk, as I have already told you, is really good for the skin. It has some whitening property. In fact, I will recommend you all, like once you get up in the morning, clean your face with the raw milk. This will really help to, you know, brighten your skin and you can easily see the difference in a month only. Second, it had lemon juice. It has also some cleansing property. And then it had green tea, which is a really good antioxidant. And the benefit of cleansing is make sure you do not have any dust or makeup on your skin. You want to do facial on a clean face. So first step is cleansing. And now once it is done, I'm going to massage it for a good 1 to 2 minutes. And once you are done with cleansing, wash your face or wipe it with a wet towel. And then I will tell you what is the second step. And now the step number 2 is scrubbing. So for scrubbing, first I'm telling you how to prepare a scrub with the green tea and then I will tell you the use of it. Now for scrubbing, take a clean bowl and now take this used green tea bag and now I'm transferring it into a bowl, empty bowl. After that, add 1 tablespoon of honey. And now you need 1/2 tablespoon of rice flour. And now I'm mixing it well. So basically, jo isme green tea leaves hain, they act as antioxidant and they are really good for acne, blackheads. So yes, and also the honey, it will moisturize your skin, and rice flour has a really good property of bleaching. So it will act as exfoliator as well as it will brighten your skin. So the consistency of this paste would be something like this.
Looking like I am applying some mehndi.
Now use of scrubbing in facial is like it really helps to exfoliate the dead skin cells, because we have a lot of accumulation of dead skin around our nose, the chin area, the mouth area. So it really helps to get rid of this. So you have to keep it rubbing on your skin for good 5 minutes. Exfoliation is really necessary, you guys. Do try to concentrate on your nose, because you get blackheads here. So do scrub there a lot. You can also take this product all the way to your neck, but because I am wearing this t-shirt which is very close to my neckline, so I can't go there. But yes, in facial there is cleaning of neck as well, so you can take it there as well. Yeah, so it's been 5 minutes that I have been scrubbing this. Now you have to wash your face and then I'll tell you what you have to do. And now the third step is steaming your face. So for that I have this steamer with me. So this is like really inexpensive, guys. I purchased it for rupees 150. So yeah, this is really inexpensive and it works really well. And if you do not have any steamer at your home, you can also dip a hand towel or a handkerchief into hot water. Just squeeze it to get rid of excess water and you can place it on your face. And be careful, do not get so close to the steam. So take it for 2 or 3 minutes, that's it, not much. So steam really helps to open up your pores and also it is easy to get rid of blackheads after steaming. So the step number 4 is massage. And to prepare the massage cream, you will need 1 tablespoon of this curd, yogurt, dahi, whatever. In this curd, add 1/2 tablespoon of green tea. And you can also add a pinch of turmeric, just a little. And now mix them well. So basically, curd in this will help to nourish your skin. It will act as a cream. Turmeric has some antibacterial properties. So it is really good for acne or breakouts, pimples and all these things. And I have added 1/2 tablespoon of green tea. And it is just because it is a good antioxidant. Start with the less product and then we will slowly take up the more. So first simply massage it onto your skin and be careful when you go close to your eyes. So start massaging, going in with upper circular motions like this. The one thing that is really important is the massage. How you massage your face. If you are doing it in a wrong way, it will really affect your skin. So I'm going to tell you the pressure points, the way you have to massage it, the direction of massaging. So it will really help your skin to, you know, breathe and look younger and youthful. So first, the upper circular motion, which is really important. And every area of your face is important. Like once you are done with your cheeks, then your chin, and the way you massage your chin and neck is like this upper direction, because if you do it like in this way, like the downward direction, it is going to, you know, sunk your face. So you have to lift up your face to look more youthful. So the direction should be like this. This motion is for your fine lines, like we all have some fine lines, smile lines, this. So it really helps to get rid of those wrinkles and fine lines. I'm taking a little more product. Now it's turn for your nose. For your nose, you have to concentrate on the tip of your nose. This is a place where blackheads and whiteheads are. This area, basically we can't reach at this area because we think that it is like unimportant. But no, this is where the dead skin accumulates. And you have to repeat all these steps like 5 to 6 times when you are doing massage. And massages for, you can do it for 6 to 7 minutes. So when you are done with your nose, it's time for the forehead. So for forehead, you have to go in like this motion. And this really helps to, you know, keep you calm and relax. Then focus on these points just above your eyebrows. Then for your eyes, take the help of your ring finger because these are the only fingers that put less pressure on this area, and this area is really delicate. So be careful. So using your ring finger, so you have to go in anti-clockwise direction. Now this will help to reduce puffiness under your eyes and get rid of dark circles because green tea is really good in that. And now close your eyes and with this finger only, try to just scroll it like this. And trust me, this is like really relaxing. And now you can go and wash your face and then I will tell you what is the final step. Alright, so I don't know whether you people can see or not, but I can clearly spot the difference, like before and after. Like my skin is really feeling fresh and breathing and glowing. So yes, I can actually spot the difference. But I don't know if the camera is doing justice or not. So moving on to the final part, this is masking. So we are going to prepare a face mask. So first let me tell you how to prepare it and then I will tell you what is the use of face mask. Alright, so take an empty bowl. You will need 1 tablespoon of besan. So besan is basically gram flour. Next step is really optional if you want to add it or not, but I am going to add a pinch of turmeric. Turmeric is haldi. Just this much if you can see. Then 1/2 tablespoon of this rose water. And then 1/2 tablespoon of this lemon juice.
Can you see, this is the juice of 2 lemons. Like,
Alright, now stir this well to make it a paste. And if you feel that the consistency is really thick, then you can add on some rose water again. And the face mask is done. Now you can apply it either with the help of the back of the spoon like this, or your fingers, or I will use this face mask brush. Best thing about this green tea facial is like it is all natural, like all natural ingredients. So yes, I really love this. Alright, so now basically some people like to keep it this way only, but I also like to apply any face mask around my eyes also, like my under eyes. So this is my personal preference. You can do it your own way. And now leave it on your face for 15 minutes. Let it dry and then I will tell you what you have to do. And please do not laugh. Do not make any facial expression. Do not stretch your face when it is dry because it is going to leave your skin with wrinkles and with lines. Because when you stretch your face or like laugh, there are some lines formed on your face. Like when you laugh, there are some lines around your eyes or your smile lines. So when you are masking, you do not have to make any facial expression, otherwise they will leave you with wrinkles and lines. So yeah, that's what I have heard of. So I believe in this thing. So yeah, let it dry and then you can wash it with normal water. Like just have a splash of water and then start scrubbing your face a little and then get rid of the mask and then I will tell you what you have to do. So wait for 15 minutes.
Till then, eat something, watch TV, tease your brother, but please do not talk. I know it's hard, but you can do this.
Alright guys, so I am back and wow. I don't know why this camera is not doing justice to the results, but clearly I can see the difference. Trust me guys, honestly, I can see the difference like before and after. Like, how many times should I repeat this? But yeah. Alright, so one thing you have to keep in mind is, like after you have done this facial, you do not have to wash your face. Wash your face means use any soap or face wash for 2 days at least. Like if I have done this in evening, tomorrow and day after tomorrow, I will not be using any face wash because this facial had all the natural ingredients. So please do not hinder this process. So yeah, once you are done with this, then you have to apply some eyes. This is totally optional. But I would recommend you to use eyes because it will help the pores to shrink. This is the thing that we need right now the most.
So I have this big ice cube with me and it is cold, but you have to.
Yes, and now it's time to apply the moisturizer and for that I'm using this Nivea moisturizer. So yeah, you need to, you know, moisturize really good, like really good. So I'm taking this much amount. I know it's a lot, but I always moisturize like a maniac. And that's it. So now let's go back to the video. Alright people, so that's it with this video. I really hope that this video is kind of helpful for you all. And if it is, then do let me know in the comment section below. Because I really want to know that whether I'm helping you in any way or not. Because I'm putting a lot of efforts to make everything done. But in return, I don't receive comments. So yeah, that really hurts. And I have so many facials also. Like DIY aloe vera facial, DIY fruit facial. For every skin type. So yeah, I want to know, should I make another DIY video on these facials or not? So let me know in the comment section below and I'll see you in my next video.